Today we want to talk a little bit more about the average rate of change and about the secant line. So I just want to make sure that these things are settled in your head. Let's go ahead, and I just want to work one problem for you, and that is for f of x equal to 3 minus 1/3 x squared, find A, the average rate of change, from x equal to negative 3 to x equal to negative 1. Okay, part B is find the equation of the secant line. Associated with x equal 3 and x equal to negative 1. And see graph both f of x and the secant line on the same graph. Okay. So let's scroll down. First, we just want to find the average rate of change of this function. So that shouldn't be too hard to do. So solution to part A. We remember the average rate of change is f of b minus f of a over b minus a, that this is the slope when I'm given a function. So in my problem, let's say a is, let's say negative 1 and b is negative 3, then f of negative 1 is equal to 3 minus 1/3 negative 1 squared. Let me see what that is. 3 minus 1/3. Should be 8/3, and f of negative 3 equals 3 minus 1/3 negative 3 squared. And I get 0. So when I just plug in, I'll plug in f of b is 0, minus 8/3 divided by b, which is negative 3, minus negative 1. I have negative 8/3 in the numerator and negative 3 plus 1 in the denominator, which should be negative 2. You can either do this on your calculator or with what you know about fractions, 8/3 divided by 2, same thing as multiplying by 1/2, should give me 4/3. And the sign should be positive. So I get a slope of 4/3, or a rate, average rate of change between these two points to be 4/3. Okay? Okay, part B, I want to find the equation of the secant line in these two points. Here, this is the slope of the secant line, which sometimes you'll see written m secant. That's the slope that we will use. Now, let's go. We'll use 4/3 as our slope. So again, let's do part B. Find the equation of the secant line. My secant line, m secant, the slope is 4/3. And I had two points. One of the points was easier than the other. I remember a point negative 3 and 0. When I plug in negative 3, I get 0 into this function. So, but this is a point on the secant line. So now I just use the point slope form of a line. Y minus y2 or y1 m x minus x2. And let's plug in y minus 0 is equal to 4/3 x minus negative 3. Y is equal to 4/3 x plus 3. Let's go ahead and multiply that out. 4/3 x plus 4. Okay, this should be the equation of the secant line right here. Four thirds x plus 4. Okay, and now for the last part, I just want to graph these on the same graph. So let me go ahead and, not in red though, I know you guys get tired of watching me draw graphs. I don't do it beforehand because I'm thinking that you're taking notes alongside of me and that you need time to draw your graph as well. I hope that you're taking notes. Okay, so let's see. I have this function, f of x, is equal to 3 minus 1/3 x squared. I almost lost it for a minute. Okay. And we can go ahead and find, let's say, maybe the vertex. Maybe I should have left a little room over here, but let's work over here, vertex. So negative b over 2a, if I rewrite this problem in a x squared plus bx plus c, there's no b, there's just an a and a c, right? So negative b over 2a is 0 over 2 times whatever, negative 1/3. It doesn't really matter what this denominator is, it's 0. And then f of 0 is equal to 3. So my vertex is the point 0, 3. So I'll put that on the graph. 0, 3. Right there. That's also the y-intercept, so I won't bother to find that. Let's find the x-intercept. So I set negative 1/3 x squared plus 3 equal to 0. And solve for x squared, negative 1/3 x squared equals negative 3. Multiply both sides by 3, or negative 3, to get rid of that 1/3. And I get x is equal to the plus or minus square root of 9, which is plus or minus 3. So that gives me 2 points, negative 3 and positive 3 here on this graph. So this is this parabolic shape. Looks something like that. Okay. Now, my equation of my secant line was y is equal to 4/3 x plus 4. So I'm going to go ahead and draw that here. I have a y-intercept of 4, and maybe I'll go down and back. So I get 1, 2, 3, 4, and over 1, 2, 3 here. I should be also passing through this point at 1, which was Because I'm going from negative 1, so I had 2 points on my graph, right? I had the point negative 3, 0, and I think negative 1 and 8 thirds, which 8 divided by 3, if you just do it real quick on your calculator, is 2 and 2 thirds. So it's just right up here. But these are the 2 points that it should be passing through. Look like that. Sorry, this is a little bit off. Hold on. Let's redraw this. That's better, maybe. Okay. So I think it looks something like this. But anyway, you see kind of between here, right in here, you have this blue line and the red line that look really close to each other. You get the red line is kind of a very close approximation, and if you look at the equation for the red line, it's much simpler than the blue line. It'd be much simpler to plug in x values. So you're getting this really close approximation, but this red line is the secant line and the blue line is your original graph. Okay? And the slope of this red line is your average rate of change of 4/3. Okay, so that's it for average rate of change. We're going to talk about instantaneous rate of change in the next video.